When it carries out a mission, it cannot be seen and is almost impossible to track. It can dive to a depth of 300 meters and stay there for 6 months before launching missiles that will fly thousands of kilometers and destroy a target as big as a country. A nuclear submarine is a real weapon of apocalypse, which only the most powerful states have. Others simply can't afford it, either financially or technologically. The crazy development race between the Soviet Union and the United States has resulted in the most powerful military rivalry in the history of mankind. Never before had mankind invested so much money in the development of destructive weapons. Nobel laureates, the smartest men of their time, politicians, and society were all focused on developing the weapons of the future. The atomic submarine monsters produced in the Soviet Union at that time still wander in the depths of the ocean, terrifying foreign intelligence services, which vainly try to track down Russian submarines. What are nuclear submarines capable of, and why the scientists involved in their development are protected by special services? Watch this video until the end to find out who dominates the nuclear submarine fleet right now and whether mankind has a chance if even one submarine fires a nuclear-tipped missile in the direction of the enemy. It is very difficult to say that the reputation of submarines is perfect. The ability to travel thousands of kilometers in silence has attracted criminals for a long time. Colombian drug barons have adapted their private submarines to transport illegal substances between countries. Right now, dozens of them are wandering the depths of the sea, carrying illegal cargoes that could not be transported any other way. The technology of other countries in submarine technology is literally being hunted. The CIA built a special drillship in the 1970s for $350 million. Fantastic money by the standards of that time. The ship pretended to collect minerals from the bottom of the ocean for scientific purposes, but in fact it was engaged in the lifting of a Soviet submarine that had previously sunk in that location. Nuclear-powered submarines, or NPS, sink quite frequently. Since 1955, a total of 9 nuclear-powered submarines have sunk, 5 Soviet, 2 Russian, and 2 US. At this questionable figure, we can say that the score is 7-2 in favor of Russia. Some submarines are at the bottom right with a nuclear arsenal on board, and it is not possible to raise them. Actually, it is possible to give it a try, but with the risk of destroying a couple of continents. The notorious Kursk of the Project 949 ANTI was the most famous catastrophe of the Russian Navy and almost the only crash that happened due to weapons malfunctions. The most common cause of the sinking of submarines is problems with the engines. Experts say that there are letters of last hope onboard the British submarines. These letters tell what must be done in case the government is destroyed by a nuclear attack of the enemy. These letters are destroyed as soon as the new prime minister takes office and gives new orders. Silent nuclear predators are shrouded in a veil of myths, which is not surprising because the level of secrecy in their production and exploitation is enormous. Journalists are kept at a distance of a cannon shot from such facilities, but sometimes the curtain of secrecy is pulled up in honor of major events. For example, in honor of the centenary of the birth of engineer Sergei Kovalyov, Russian journalists were first allowed on the TK-20 Severstal. One of the nuclear-powered strategic cruisers of Project 941 Akula is known as Shark, which was created under the leadership of the genius developer. The media did not find out much, but there is enough information to understand the destructive power of this class of submarines. The creation of the heavy missile submarine of strategic use was in the hands of the top-secret Rubin Design Bureau, starting from the 1970s. Even then, the KGB was already keeping an eye on the developers and their family members, regularly identifying agents of Western intelligence services who tried various ways to contact the nuclear workers and obtain information on details that constituted state secrets. The knowledge of the engineers was more expensive than money, and the foreigners were not able to buy this information. At that time, Soviet engineers made a real doomsday weapon. The R-39 RIF, one missile could launch 10 warheads of 100 kilotons, each at a distance of up to 10,000 kilometers. Moreover, the Shark has 20 missile tubes, and each missile has 10 nuclear warheads. The combined destructive power of 200 warheads is 1,400 times more than the power of the bomb dropped on Hiroshima. It is still a mystery how to defend against such a hurricane of missiles, each of which is a real Armageddon. It is not surprising that the boats of this project literally terrified the NATO leadership. These missiles were very large, and the Akula was built based on them. 173 meters in length and a height comparable to a 9-story building. It's hard to call it a boat, it's a small town. The main advantage of the submarine is the ability to go underwater at 50 kilometers per hour and remain silent at the same time. Only 6 of these submarines have been made, but now there are 3 left. They are listed in the Guinness Book of World Records as the largest nuclear submarines on Earth. The anti-submarine rubber coating weighs 800 tons alone, which is more than the entire American nuclear submarine NR-1. With its body, it can break through ice up to 2.5 meters thick. Akulas are so enormous that it was necessary to equip a berth line for them, develop a system of loading missiles, and even build a special transport, a rocket ship. These ships did not last long, their exploitation was very expensive. Severstal is now in reserve and is waiting for a decision on disposal. According to the general director of the top secret shipyard, Project 941 submarines are not required anymore as the technology has stepped forward. Now the crew on the Severstal is reduced, but the life of the ship is maintained, 24-hour armed watch is kept, fire safety and unsinkability are monitored. The nuclear reactors, of course, are brought to a safe condition. The Aculas were replaced by the Bores. Their history began back in 96 when the first submarine of the new type was laid down in Severodvinsk. Fleet financing in the 90s was unstable, and that affected the timing of the submarine construction. The first in a class of new submarines was the Yuri Dolgoruki, which joined the Northern Fleet in 2013. Now the Russian Navy has five Project 955 Boris submarines, the Alexander Nevsky and Vladimir Monomakh, which are serving in the Pacific Ocean, Prince Vladimir and Prince Oleg, which join the list of modern Russian nuclear submarines that carry the names of Russia's former rulers, joined their fellows quite recently. In many respects, the Boreys are superior to their competitor, the United States Ohio, which is the backbone of the US strategic submarine fleet. The immersion depth of the Ohio is 365 meters, which is 35 meters less compared to the Russian submarine Monster. The creation of Russian engineers gives a head start both in running speed and duration of autonomous voyage. As an element of the nuclear triad, the Borei Project submarines are designed to destroy. The nuclear-powered submarines are armed with 16 modern Bulava solid-fuel ballistic missiles. Each carries 10 nuclear warheads with a capacity of up to 150 kilotons. In one salvo, the missile cruiser can destroy any city on Earth regardless of its size. It won't be a problem for a small country as well. The creators do not reveal the technical features of the Borei for obvious reasons, carefully saying that the ships of the new type have a number of advantages. Well, let's believe them on their word and hope that the sailors will not have to test the capabilities of the super submarines in practice. It will be better for the entire mankind. There are also multi-purpose submarines. They carry out other tasks, destroying ships, other submarines, and tactical targets on the ground. The most advanced of these submarines is the American SEAWOLF, the main feature of which is the highest level of stealth and lethal weapons on board. One such submarine carries up to 50 Harpoon or Tomahawk missiles. It costs so much that even the bottomless US defense budget could only afford three of these submarines. The Russian Navy has a classified SCIF missile system that can be on the bottom of the ocean autonomously for many years, and at the right moment on command hit the specified target by firing missiles flying at hypersonic speed. This is not a submarine, which is why we did not include the SCIF in this video. There is almost no information about this complex on the internet, so if you are interested in learning about the unique bottom-based missile, which, by the way, is a nuclear weapon, let us know in the comments. Modern nuclear-powered submarines can wander silently underwater for months, invisible to their enemies. They are designed to remain silent, ensuring the strategic security of the nation. At any second of the day or night, they are charged to plunge the enemy into the abyss of chaos, following a devastating nuclear strike. By the way, if we focus on movies, especially American ones, one might conclude that submarine wars happen on a regular basis. This is certainly not true. History records only one authentic case in which two submarines fought underwater. Most of the tasks that nuclear submarines carry out involve long periods of covert deployment off the enemy's coast. Of course, the voyage must begin in a secret location, otherwise the boat can be tracked. That is why submarines are repaired at unique indoor bases, which are as big as a megalopolis. The most important facilities of these bases are deep underground in special bunkers. Originally, submarines were diesel-powered, but at the dawn of atomic research, scientists quickly realized that the enormous amount of energy released by the splitting of the atom could be used to generate electricity. The reactor makes it possible to travel at high speed for longer periods of time. Refueling of the latest generation of boats is required only once in 25 years, which eliminates the need for regular surfacing to replenish fuel supplies. The only disadvantage of these units is the extremely high price. So if you want to buy one of these things to swim in a city lake, prepare a few billion dollars. But experts are confident, as oil prices rise, nuclear submarines may become more cost-effective than ships with traditional engines. The Americans and the British have stopped using non-nuclear submarines altogether. The Russian submarine fleet has a mixed lineup. In general, only five countries have nuclear-powered submarines. Apart from the US and Russia, the elite club includes France, England, and China. The rest are using diesel-electric submarines, or have no submarine fleet at all. The evolution of nuclear-powered submarine predators has been gradual. Developments of the first generation were experimental. The submarines of the next generation were not much different. While finding some inspiration in how nature handled the task of moving underwater, engineers copied the fins of fish, installing their metal analogs on board the boat. The best minds of the time struggled to optimize the hull and increase underwater speed. By the way, one of the submarines of this generation of Project 661, the Anchar, set a speed record which has not been beaten to this day. For submarines of this size, it could cruise at a fantastic speed of over 80 kilometers per hour. The third generation boats had quite different characteristics. It is necessary to pay tribute to the Americans. At this stage, they were the ones who wrote the history. The boats, Ohio, and the Los Angeles had reactors capable of operating without recharging for up to 11 years. Thanks to interesting engineering solutions, the quality of life of the crew on board improved as well. Even for superpowers. Manufacturing such things is extremely expensive, that's why many third-generation boats are still in service. And now, welcome to the present. The fourth generation is the most up-to-date. These boats began to appear in the early 90s, which by historical standards was literally yesterday. The submarines received a new type of sound-absorbing coating, composite materials, and long-life reactors. Since the third-generation boats suffered several disasters, the design features of the fourth-generation boats were their own autonomous escape pods and a completely isolated reactor. Modern submarines are typically characterized by unprecedentedly low noise levels. Engineers managed to fit 50 cruise missiles into American submarines. Modern deep-sea Raptors are equipped with universal launchers with drum magazines to launch torpedoes and wing missiles. So far, the fifth generation exists only on paper. The country that will be the first to develop these monsters will obviously begin to dominate underwater. The American Journal of the National Interest has published a list of the five most dangerous combat submarines in the world. The list included only operating submarines and those that will enter service in the near future. Only submarines from Russia and the US made the top five, and Russian submarines occupied the largest part of the list. Boreal Project submarines are recognized by experts as one of the most intimidating. The American authors of the rating have not forgotten about the achievements of their own submarine fleet. They call the Ohio-class submarines the most deadly U.S. nuclear submarines. Experts agree on one thing. If a single missile is launched from nuclear submarines, humanity will be thrown back centuries at best. At worst, it would simply end its existence as species. And everything will be roughly like in these pictures. But could this be the test of sanity? Or is there no sense in mentioning the reasonableness of mankind? Write in the comments what you think about this topic. See you later in our future videos.